5 hours and 35 minutes before the launch, fuel begins loading into the external tank. The fuel comes from the white spherical tanks on the edges of the launch pad. Remember that the SRBs already have their solid fuel inside of them. At T-minus 3 hours, the astronauts leave for the launch pad and begin to enter the orbiter vehicle. Since the shuttle is vertical on the launch pad, all of the seats are in the laid-back position. Most missions had 7 astronauts, 3 in the middeck and 4 in the flight deck. There are no windows on the middeck, so some of the astronauts won't be able to enjoy the view on the way up. There's a lot of excitement coming up to the moment of liftoff. However, if there are any problems such as mechanical failures or even bad weather, then the launch will be delayed or even canceled until another day. This is called a launch scrub, and it can happen all the way up until just a few seconds before liftoff. At T-minus 7 minutes and 30 seconds, the orbiter access arm is slowly retracted. If there is an emergency, they can quickly bring it back into place. At T-minus 3 minutes and 45 seconds, main engine gimbal test to make sure that it's working correctly. T-minus 2 minutes and 55 seconds, the beanie cap is lifted and the gaseous oxygen vent arm is retracted. At T-minus 10 seconds, activate the hydrogen burn-off system. And no, this does not actually start the engines. That happens up here inside of the combustion chamber. What these sparks do is ignite any excess hydrogen. This hydrogen can cause an unexpected explosion at launch if it isn't taken care of. At T-minus 6.6 seconds, the 3 main engines ignite. All 3 of them must work correctly or they will shut down and abort the launch. At the moment of liftoff, many things happen simultaneously. The gaseous hydrogen vent arm is retracted from the external tank. The 2 connections at the tail service mast will retract. The 8 hold-down bolts will detonate, which frees the shuttle, and then both SRBs ignite. For their journey into space, the shuttle is mostly flown by the autopilot. Of course, the astronauts can still take over if they need to. Shortly after clearing the tower, they do what's called the roll program, to get the shuttle so that it's heads down for most of the ascent into space. This reduces the aerodynamic stress on the wings. It will also allow the astronauts to see the curve of the Earth as they ascend into space. Now, as we keep gaining more and more speed, the air in the atmosphere will create pressure on the front of the spacecraft. Then as we get higher, the air starts to thin out. They use the term max